at the burning bush in Exodus chapter 3. We found in verse, thank you, Lord, chapter 3, thank you, Lord, Exodus chapter 3 and verse 14. And God said unto Moses, I am that I am. And he said, thus shall I say unto the children of Israel, I am has sent me unto you. Put out there for a little while, because we found that this reveals several important facts about God. Can I share them with you right here? I'm trying to move. You might be wondering how I'm trying to get on out your way. Yeah, to the Lord is good. Yeah, well, he revealed, I am revealed himself, thank you, Lord, to Moses as God is a person. He, thank you, Lord, not an abstract, physiological idea, not an animatic, thank you, Lord, inanimate object, nor an illusion. I am revealed himself as God is self-existence. Nothing caused or brought him into being. I am revealed himself as, thank you, Lord, God is self-sufficient. He doesn't need the angels, and he don't need humans, thank you, Lord, or anything else. He can't, thank you, Lord, contribute anything to God that he does not already possess. I am revealed himself as God is eternal. Thank you, Lord. He has always been and he will always be. Thank you, Lord. In Revelation chapter 21 and verse 6, he gives further confirmation of him being eternal. He reveals himself as I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. Then he goes on over into Revelation 22 and 13, and then he just asks, not only am I Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, but he says, I'm the first and the last. I didn't come to worry, but truly the Lord is good. Thank the Lord. I am revealed him as God. He is unchangeable. Thank you, Lord. He never differs from himself. Who he was in creation, he is today. Thank you, Lord. And he will be back on tomorrow. Yeah, the theme that we have for this fellowship, thank you, Lord, Hebrews 13 and 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. To the Lord is good. And I don't mean no harm, but church, we can trust God to be as he revealed himself to be. Thank you, Lord. Truly, God is good there. Thank you, Lord. And that means that since he, thank you, Lord, never changes, then he is inescapable. That means he just won't go away. Yeah, I know what I'm saying is true. True, the Lord is good, and his mercies endure forever. What that means, church, if we ignore him here on this earth, we will not be able to ignore him when we stand before him at the day of judgment. True, the God is good. But I want you to understand, but considering this, if you will, thank you, Lord, unlike God's many blessings that he gives unto us, thank you, Lord, which are wholly undeserving, God just blesses us when we don't deserve being blessed. I don't know who you think you are. But none is worthy to, thank you, Lord, of the glory and honor but God. Yeah, I'll rest for a little while. I'm trying to move. See, we got to understand it is only by his mercy and his grace. Truly, the Lord is good. See, our blessing God through praise is done out of the understanding that he is the true and living praise worship God. He is the creator of the universe. And thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We found that because of an adoption. Y'all bear for a little while. He is our Father.